Welcome back. Let's track Brownie at the application level, in which we follow the development of a project that's using Brownie critically from beginning to end. Welcome to our Curve Funder series. You probably know that Curve DAO can direct emissions to any pool that it likes, but it turns out it can actually direct funds to anything it likes. So several members of the community had the brilliant idea of building a crowdfunding site that can earn Curve emissions as voted on by the Curve DAO. A bunch of Curve heavy hitters are helping to build this, and of course, they're using Brownie. So I wanted to walk through how you can actually use Brownie in an application level. Now, none of this is an endorsement of this project. Ultimately, it's going to be put up for a DAO vote. The DAO can do what it wants with it, but it's a pretty interesting concept. It's called CRVFunder, and we're going to be tracking periodically. The important thing with an application is how are you going to work with a team? You have a great team of heavy hitters, as I mentioned here. How can everyone collaborate in GitHub? We've previously been using GitHub entirely on our own. So looking at this recent commit within CRVFunder, you might have noticed on several more advanced levels of GitHub, once commits are made and pushed and pull requests are opened, it adds some nice checks. It's going to go through several different checks to make sure that the commit passes, running different actions, in some cases connecting Brownie tests to make sure that all the Brownie tests are able to run and execute before you commit something. It's a very useful way to integrate Brownie's testing capabilities and make sure that you're actually doing good commits that don't break the work of any test environment. Well, fortunately, Brownie makes this, as always, very, very easy. In a previous lesson, we looked at Brownie mixes. We use this to, for example, bake a basic Brownie token. One of the mixes that exists is called GitHub Actions. This is a great place to start and create a collaborative environment. In this case, the GitHub Actions mix contains a number of things, including some linting checks. Linting tools are tools that will look over your code and make sure that it looks nice and passes all the coding standards that you put into it. In this case, this is using Black, Flake8, and isort, three important linters that are commonly used. The pre-commit for the linting hooks means that before you can publish this, it's going to run the linting checks, and if there's any issues with it, it's going to flag an error or in some cases not be able to publish it. As mentioned, Brownie makes it very easy to get going. If you'd like to start your repository using GitHub Actions, simply Brownie bake GitHub Actions. It's going to download the repository and it's going to create the GitHub Actions repository. You can rename this as you like. Within it, there's a number of important scripts, and one important one is actually hidden. It's the preconfigured.yaml. This is one of the commits that GitHub looks for when you're making a commit. And you can see within this is the logic requiring some pre-commit hooks, such as running Black, running Flake8, and running isort. When we look at how CRVFunder is managing it, it's only a few commits in, but they have established their pre-commit. And within, for example, some of these tools, Black has a few different hooks like checking the white space, checking the end of file fixer. But mostly it's the exact same. So again, if you are establishing a new project in which you're going to be working from scratch with a number of people, it's a really good idea to start from the GitHub Actions commit. The GitHub Actions mix. If you're using the GitHub Actions mix, you're going to have a great framework in which you can work collaboratively. In the next unit, we're going to look at some of the interesting ways that the new CRVFunder is using Brownie tests.